Alrighty guys, so we're going to be going live with the knife round on the second map, and it's going to be Team Kingwin versus Gambit on Kingwin's map pick, Overpass. And I'm going to be joined once again by Switch. Switch played Jay, and this time he's not going to be opening up a bowl of cocoa. How you doing, mate?
No, actually, I already did. Just during that break, I was like, oh, God, I'm feeling quite tired. I'm bored of this break. I might as well have myself some energy. No, I'm kidding, obviously. I did. I just had one because I felt like it. Yeah, so Overpass. This one we kind of both predicted during the break that we were looking for a Team Kingwin kind of victory just because they've had a bit more experience on this particular map. Yes, Gambit have got the better percentage of victory, but when it comes down to HLTV records, Team Kingwin have a lot more matches under their belt. So I'm just going off the experience game that Kingwin probably better off to win this. It will be. Excuse me, this is why you do not drink Coke before a stream goes live. It will be the armor buy-ups for all players and the utility buy on Rowlin. And Zeus with a double flashbang and the fuse kit over for his CT side. Dozier, meanwhile, is going to go aggressive. The flashbang works out so well. Blinds off so many players, but he's only able to get one. Zeus, thank God, comes in from the background and gets one, so it makes it all worth it on a 4-on-3 situation to the favor of the Gambit side.
So what a fantastic entry here. Now Miku going to be pushing in. He takes down 1-2. These headshots popping out hard and fast. Hobby going to be left in a 1v1. The pressure's building. Diffuse kit is not in hand for him. But Miku has no idea where he is. He's got 3 kills. He's going to be pushing back over towards short and looking in for the rotate. But no, it's a little bit of a fake there. He's going to be coming straight back onto the B site. And Hobbit, no sound to give it away yet. We're waiting for the bomb plant. There it is. And the push up from Hobbit's going to be coming out. He's going to be able to spot him out. Goes into the tag. Hits him and eventually lands the headshot. Hobbit not quite realizing that there's only one player. Not able to counter 1-1. We're going to be seeing that the first win come out on Gambit side on the CT. So that's going to be looking quite nice. Look at that. That's actually going to be a team ace. Hobbit last man standing, but that's going to be one kill on each player. That's not too often you see that happening.
No, definitely. That's a very little interesting point you make there. But Gambit, I mean, particularly Hobbit, not looking too far on point in particular after killing the last player and looking back towards Monster, expecting there to be more. I mean, not sure if that's a good effect of the break or whether just wasn't in the right place at the right time. But either way, they will get them to the defuse and the first round on the board. But Kingwin also going to be taking a little bit of unusual strategy. We usually see teams saving this round after getting the bomb plant and just try and go for the rifles in round number 3. But for Kingwin in this case, they're going to go ahead and try it for the straight up force buy. It's going to be the UMPs out, the Tech 9, the AK, the Deagle. I'm just not 100% sure whether this is actually a good play coming out from the Polish team. I definitely not something I agree with. I usually go prefer to see the AKs out one round earlier, but I mean, you know, it could work out to their favor. As I say that though, 2 kills do immediately come in for the CT side as Gambit roll their way on through. Mo's going to have the scout taking one headshot. Michi finding a trade it back, but there's still 2 players left alive for the Kingwin side, so not much you can do here.
That's gonna be very difficult. I mean, picking up 1 kill. He's going to be Zeus straight onto Miku. Not going to be looking so good for Marzinho. He's only got for Ted 9 and the AK picked up by Zeus. And they're going to get punished for buying these weapons too early. And that's really going to leave Kingwin in a sore place as they're going to have to eco this round. And they should really just buy up nothing. But we are going to be seeing a few pistols come out from their side. Gareth for the P250. I'm sure we'll see Marzinho opt in for a pistol as well. There you go. And that should really be out on their side. But no, another one comes out for Miku. So that's very limited. But the AK on Zeus this early on, it's going to be a very nice ad for them. And they've also got the sort of the FAMAS, the UMP, and the double M4 setup. No utility on the side of Kingwin, as you expect. They need to save every penny they can. This is going to be a painful move here on through. And I mean, we mentioned that obviously Kingwin have potentially a higher chance of doing this because they've got more experience on HLTV, but I'm not quite sure if that's all properly recorded because it only really states that. Gambit have very few games on. I think only just around sort of 11 or 10. I can't remember off the top of my head there. But Team Kingwin, they've got like 39 games on there. 6-1. Zeus, though, going to be entering into this. Gets the first kill on Zeus, well, looking for another. He's going to get tagged, though. Down to 73, and the push comes down and in, but not going to be effective. Miku going to get denied by Dozier and his favored UMP. He's going to be able to pick up another one. Not quite a second one. Marzinho going to be able to get the trade off on Dozier. But Mo is going to be coming in from short and going to be able to finish off Marzinho. As you'd expect, not really too much fast-paced action here.
And this is why I don't agree with force buying on the second round, regardless of whether you get a bomb plon or not. Because for Kinguin, that was just going to be the mop up. If they had those AKs in their hands, they could have shut down Gambit's conversion rounds. But now Gambit are going to have full play of those conversion rounds, and they're going to have all the money in the bank for the next couple of rounds. They're even going to get an AWP out on the board. And Kinguin had the perfect chance to shut that down, but they denied it. Instead, they're going to go for the AKs on this round, and they're going to try and shut them down before they can do any particular damage to their side. And already going to go for a slightly different play. Out towards the Fountain and Park areas. Bomb's been left alone, and there'll be Marzinho lurking around the back towards the monster area. He's going to get tagged up immediately by early aggression coming in from the two CTs on the site. I think that's Zeus and Dozier, but I can't see the numbers too great from my particular screen. For them, already a great start for the Gambit side, as Kinguin will take a couple of tag damages and now try to go for that map control to try to get the bomb down and potentially around here.
Yeah, that was some early damage through the wall. He's actually wallbanging him with the AK-47 that was currently dropped to him on that early aggression. Mayo, though, he's going to be able to get the kill onto Miku, already taking advantage into this fourth round, going in over to the favor of the CTs. They may have a Famous, but that AWP is going to be able to open them up. So, Force 40s left alive. We're going to be seeing the push over towards A come out from them, the bomb on long. But unfortunately for them, there's going to be four CTs there ready and waiting. And Dozier with the Famous is ready to rotate. He's already heading up towards Graffiti. They've just given up B, almost. Not quite fully, but still at that point. So flashes coming out in from both sides. Smokes as well, denying this push. 35 seconds left on the clock. Time is ticking. Utility is very tight on both teams. This double smoke setup from the T, though, is going to be coming out. We're going to be seeing it executed. Raylan dropping the first one. Ferlin with the second. It's not going to be enough. Adrian's going to be waiting around this corner. The flash is going to be coming in. He's going to go large. He takes that one. The spray is going to be working perfectly as Hobbit picks up one. The Drake comes out. Malzino is going to be able to drop one. He's going to get sprayed through the wall and in the open down to 43 HP. Last man standing. Going to have to go large. He's around the corner. Takes down Zeus, but he's going to get attacked to 16 HP. And he's going to have to run away here as Dozier's hungry. He wants to try and pick up a different weapon. And he's actually going to head back. He's just going to opt in to try and find the AK and take this through to the next round. Zeus may have dropped his, but they're going to drop another round onto the board for themselves. Gambit, 4-0 currently in their favor, and it's not their map. And remember, guys, on Cobblestone, they actually managed to win it out 16-8. They did drop quite a few rounds when they switched over towards the CT side. Kinguin did better on the T side, but at the moment, their aggressive play with the force up earlier has really punished them here.
And I wanted to highlight Mo and Adren in particular over on the defensive of the A site. Mo with that first punch, taking the man advantage for Kinguin. Adren just cleaning up the rest of the pieces with his double kill. All in all, that just shut down all that Kinguin could have potentially had to offer in that round on both fronts. In particular, now they will have themselves the Tech-9s, the AKs, like you said, definitely screwed themselves in this particular round, as they will just have themselves, well, not much to work with again. Once again, just that AK in play for the Polish team. In fact, Michi's only going to go full eco with a P250 and nothing else. And it's going to be quick executions from this T side over there. Dozy gets himself a double kill. Mazzini is going to get the one back. They still will be dealing with a spray down from Adren. Three kills come in from Gerard and Mazzini and Ferlin. All to close it out with a very easy triple kill from the Gambit team. A five-round loss bonus for the Kinguin side. We'll get themselves out with a full buy here. And this is where they should try and do some damage.
This is where they have to do some damage. They need to try and get some rounds on the wall before Gambit gained it too much of a lead. Last game, we did see Gambit go up six rounds before Kinguin really did too much to do against them. So we're going to be seeing the early Molotov come out. No, Miku does decide against it. Maybe they're scared of the train. So Dozier has got his UMP, and really the meta is strong with this one. He really is loving that UMP play. We saw him last map go absolutely hammering away with it, and he's going to be doing it again this game, and he's going to be situated down over towards the monster area, holding off that tunnel in case the push comes out. But Gary is going to have to give up with the AWP back off. Adrian, he's going to be in toilets, backing up the AWP player on the CT side. Mo, holding over towards long. Party area is where the T is going to be looking to descend into. The smoke over towards long, the flash as well, actually. They are going to be able to peek out Mo, who was fully flashed. That was a good one. The counter flash comes out, the peek comes out as well, but the AK has spotted him. The tab comes out, same to 75. Raylan going to be able to take down Adren, but the incendiary grenade, get my words out, is going to force him to back off. Carry it onto Mo. Advantage slowly slipping over towards the T side, but as I say, that Dozier, he's going to get dropped as well. Only two CTs left alive. This is how we need Kinguin to be playing. The rotations come in. The bomb site B has been taken over. Malzinho finally killed onto Zeus, taking full control here. Hobbit. And we left wondering what has gone on.
There's just no response from the Gambit side. There's not much the Hobbit can do other than say that AWP look for an exit frag, but even he's going to be denied that as Kingwin roll their way onto their first at long last. A bit of a different round coming out there in Gambit. I'm not sure where they were. Just no responses, no kills, barely finding themselves the tag damages. And in the end of the day, it is just going to be Kingwin with their first. Gambit, however, saving lots of money over the last couple of rounds. Will have themselves the AWP out once again with the full M4 buy-up. So all in all, not that bad here. We'll see them where they set up. King Green going to go once again out towards the connector area. Several players out towards Fountain and Parkway. Three players going aggressive with some grenade damage over to Roland. Only 4 HP he'll lose. It's not that much. And Gambit, well, they will just go for that early aggression and back the hell off to try and set up defensive angles for King Green now. They'll also take things slowly and look for that first pick on their T side.
Yeah, they really need to play for this. Play for the open then, and then take full advantage of that. Explode out and go in for the rotation like they did last game, or even just full on stick to it. So we've got the push over towards long. They haven't met head on with anyone so far. This is going to give them a lot of information. But what it won't give them information of is this boost, but the incendiary grenade is going to make them back off and think twice of keeping that boost. So Hobbit is going to be the man left in towards toilets. The flashes, smoke coming out. They're going to be backing off here, but the entrance coming in. Miku finding the head on Adrian and onto Hobbit as Hobbit takes down Raylan. It's a perfect trade off now. And the T is going to be looking to dedicate themselves to one spot, but I don't think it's going to be happening too soon as the rotation is going to be coming in. But it's going to be over towards the B site as the CTs are going to be saving their guns. They're not going to be playing aggressively here. They don't have the economy to play with it. If they save these guns, they'll be able to buy weapons in the next round. It's a smart move. A site would be very hard to try and take back from underneath. They're going to have to play aggressively and play very dangerously. So they opted in to just go for the easier route, and that's just to save.
Yeah, it makes sense at this point. Gambit's economy not looking on the best of situations. Of course, high investment in that round. Full M4 utility and the AWP on Mal. And it does just not worth it to go ahead and throw that all away when you put so much into that round. And Kingwin will have the second. Gambit only on a 2-round loss bonus. So, all in all, great call from Zeus to hold back his team and to keep them from, just generally falling into the clutches of an full eco round. So for them, 2 rappers and an AWP will be great for them to work with in the next round. They can do some serious damage to Kingwin, and they can get themselves some money to try and work with for the end, or sorry, for the round afterwards that. So 5-2 now, Kingwin will buy back in full. Gambit, well, actually, the money's not even that bad, so they can actually force buy on Hobbit and Adren, and I think they will go ahead and do that. So there it is, the full buy-up coming back again for the Gambit side. And this is actually going to be a very interesting round for them because it should put them on an eco, a relative eco, if they do end up losing it here. As Kingwin will once again go what looks to be a fast play out towards the B monster area. Bombs on its way over there, most of the force is there. So, for all intents, the Polish side do look like they want to commit to the monster areas. Here we go, connection coming in.
And then Fern going to be able to pick up the first kill onto Zeus, trying to follow up, but Dozer is going to have to do a lot of work here. But it's a grenade coming out, but the Smoke's going to save his ass there as he's going to be backing out, leaving it in a 4-on-2. And sorry, 4-on-5. What am I talking about? Maths is hard. Dozier, though, is going to be left to 2 HP. Playing still aggressively over towards Toxic Barrels. That's an interesting play. Hobbit going to be looking to back him up. Miku in a very difficult situation. If he tries to pull back, he's going to get taken out, but he takes down Hobbit. 12 HP player gets the advantage now. The AWP player coming out from Mo. He gets the kill, but drops to 6 HP. Single grenade could take him out. Now, Raylan, look at this. He's coming up behind him. This is a sneaky move here. Look to take out Mo. If he can take him out, that's a crucial player. He's coming in from behind. He doesn't realize he's there. Raylan, is he going to go in for the knife? Look at this play. He gets the headshot. Carry on to Adrian. Leaving one player left alive, and that's going to be Dozier with 2 HP to try and clutch this out in a 1-versus-4 situation. He spotted him out, but he's waiting. He spots out. Marzinho does a little bit of damage, but he's going to get dropped without getting a single kill against these guys. He did drop down Miku earlier on, but isn't able to follow it up, and staying alive that whole time is a little bit difficult. And that sneaky play from Raylan is absolutely beautiful.
Yeah, definitely. For Gambit now, not much. Well, they've got a bit of money, but I mean, it doesn't seem to be too worth it to invest, but I do say that, and look at this, they're going to get themselves out with the full spy. So, you know, what do I know about professional Counter-Strike? Not only just the caster of the winner of the Community Caster Challenge last time, it's no good, dude. No, I know nothing. It's going to be the 2M4s, AWP out for Mal, and the FAMAS out for Dozier. Adrenaline going to force spy into a CZ75, so definitely a difficult round here for the Gambit team. Team Kingwin, of course, have themselves the full AK and AWP buyout with a lot of utility to work with as well. So Yeah, on all forms, pretty much a better buy from the Kinguin side. And Gambit putting all they can into these force buys is going to come up short. Eventually, they're going to have to eco, which I think should be in the next round. Because, well, the reserves are gone. $100, $50 is all they've managed to find on any individual player. And Kinguin will once again slow things down. Spread across the map, they've got one player pushing up towards the middle area. Rylan will he find that first pick. And that would be a great start for Kinguin to start rolling their way on towards the site. He will keep and find Hobbit. So there we are. First pick for Kinguin, 5-on-4 situation. And now the CTs will try to go aggressive, see if they can push one back. And they will do so.
And Dozer picking up that kill, that is fantastic. Now the T's looking to try and dedicate themselves over towards the A side. Mo, though, exposes himself a little bit too much, but gets the kill onto Miku. The trade doesn't come out though from Gary. He wasn't playing a little bit. He wasn't playing aggressive enough. The Molly gonna be coming out. The bomb gonna be going down any moment. But the kill has to come out. Adrian does get popped. Mo as well. The headshot's gonna get popped. Gonna be left in a 2v3 situation. Gary gonna be able to take down Zeus, and now it's all gonna be down to Dozio once again to try and clutch this out. But his head is gonna be exposed, and Raylan doing what he does best, racking up those kills there. He played sneakily last round. This time just head on. Currently 6-6 on the scoreboard, but still doing fantastically here. It's currently 5-4 on the board. This could be the equalizer round, and most likely will be from Kinguin, unless Gambit can pull the rabbit out of the hat. Magic trick with this eco round coming out for them. Two Deagles, the two CZs, and the USP. So, Jon Snow, what do you expect from this round?
I want to see Gambit go abracadabra and find themselves in 6 rounds. No, but all seriousness, this one should just be a round that goes for Kinguin. So I actually want to talk really quickly about that long area, because I think that the T side need to be very scared of going towards that long area. Because Mo, whenever he's watching that with the AWP, he can very easily take those kills. I don't think he's missed a single shot down the long area with his CT side. So for Kinguin, probably best to be a little bit more careful in the future when taking that particular position and trying to push in towards the A site, because Gambit, they've got a serious strength in positioning over towards that long. So, well, I mean, it could prove to be more viable in the gun rounds. For now, though, it is just an eco, which Kinguin are just going to be able to mop up so easily. Now there's going to be the bomb going down further and trying to watch out for Adrian. And we'll find him eventually. There we are. There's an AK out of play for the Gambit side. Mo now back towards the A site. Nothing he can do here other than try and maybe look for a rifle somewhere across the board, which actually, well, the rifle would be over towards short. So they've locked that one out. It will just be the save coming on through, and Kinguin will even things up at 5-5.
I find it very, very confusing why Adrian decided to go for that one. He had full armor, he had an AK. So that's a massive investment to be able to save up into the next round. So that would have been better then trying to go in for the kills there, because there's a very low chance of him being able to try and pull up a miracle and get the kill. It's like Mo here, trying to get those kills, a little bit too aggressive. Only dropping that CZ though. That's where it's like, fine, okay, that's fine. But now the CTs, their economy is still like half that, and it's going to be even less when they've actually bought up. So if Adrenaline being able to save that extra little cash going forward, that could have been an AWP in the hands of the CTs and saved a little bit of extra cash. Whereas they're now all down to crumbs and absolutely nothing in their pockets, apart from 350 on Zeus. So I still rack my brains of like, why you do that. But moving forward, we have got the AWP set up versus them, and Hobbit going to be pushing up aggressively. Raylan going to get dropped. This is a fantastic play. Exactly what they needed to do, and Mo backing him up with the AWP playing up in towards sort of picnic area. This new grenade going to be coming in as well. Shut them off, so they're not going to be able to do too much. That kill through the smoke is absolutely dirty as Ferdinand watches his friend's body burn smoke away in that fire there. Now Miles looking to make an entrance in towards B. He's going to be facing him against the T's. Zeus peeking up against him, but Dozer are going to be countering the peek from Toxic Bow. Is going to be able to drop him. Now Miku and Furlan, last two T's left alive, trying to gather up their options and decide what to do.
Yeah, not much they can really do here. Kinguin getting a little bit too complacent after the last couple of rounds out towards that middle area, lost that first pick, backed off from that. Okay, we can still do this, and then just ended up walking straight into the spray through the smoke. So for them, not looking great at all. Dozy also with the kill of his own turns it into a 2-on-5. So for Kinguin, well, this next push is going to be pretty crucial, and already Mo set up to deal with it. AWP, and like I said, he is so deadly. Mishu and Ferdinand probably ought to be a little bit more scared of this, as Adren's also there to get the info. Mo is watching the short area just in case they do end up pushing. So AWP pick. Hello, Ferdinand. Good shot onto Adren. Mo now knows it, and now he's going to peek. As soon as those utility lands, he takes the first shot, and this should be the second coming on through. He stands there like a rock, but still an AWP to deal with in the form of Ferdinand. 1 versus 4 and 15 seconds, he may just have to save.
But unfortunately, I think that's going to get denied. I mean, Dozier's here. He hears the footsteps. They're going to be in closing in on him, and they're going to wait for the time to count out. They want to shut down the economy of Kingwin if they force this guy up to absolute everything with no round loss bonus. That's going to be very painful, but they're not playing aggressive enough. They're going to let him be able to get away with this one as he just hides away in toilet. So that's an AWP into this next round, and he already had 14k. That's a ridiculous amount of money to go through to the next round. He drops the AWP off over towards Gary. And on the CT side, even though they won that round, they're going to have to recover two full sets, sort of buy, so that's going to drop their economy even lower. Whereas on the CT side, they've still got enough money to buy them into the next round, even if they lose this one. They don't care. They can even buy up an AWP. It's really actually looking still very positive for Kingwin. They could shut down the economy of Gambit if they can win this equalizer round. So we've got an aggressive player coming out from Hobbit. This time it's not going to work out for him. He doesn't go for those sprays. The AWP wasn't shutting him off. It's actually holding over towards long. We have got two T's though, pushing further in towards mid. And look at that connector push as well. We're going to see Ferlin push up. And this push in towards mid is going to be able to help them take control of this. The boost, nice interesting one as well. That's going to give them some early information. We're going to see him jump over, get the flash out. Hobbit's going to be backing off as well. He is slightly flashed. He's going to get sprayed down, but Zeus, he's going to get the kill onto Marzinho. Two CTs dropped quite low here.
First pick for Gambit, already a good start. Hobbit's going to get rolled and nicely done. And it is just kind of Gambit rolling on through with the momentum of these kills and not much coming out for the Kingwin side. I mean, it will be one challenge from Ferlin back towards the CT area, but Dozy's even going to pick this one up. So very similar situation as we saw on Kingwin's first round on their board, when, you know, Gambit were just unable to respond to anything that Kingwin were able to dish out. Finally, it's going to be the opposite situation. Mo gets it. Jero doesn't expect where Mishu is coming from. He's going to be the lone man alive on a 1v4. Bombs and CT controls are nothing he can do, and Kingwin have kind of lost this one. But, you know, you were talking about how Kingwin do have some extra buybacks here, but if Gambit can get themselves a couple of rounds on the board, by the time they actually manage to weaken Kingwin's economy to a point where it will be an eco from them, they would have won their half, and at that point, it would have been a... an eco coming out from Kingwin, so they'll have themselves such a good round. I'm trying to analyze here, but Mishu is
not gonna work.
Pulling off three kills, four kills potentially coming in for the T player. He's not going to have enough time to get the bomb down, but oh my god, like
you know you're talking
I'm
about.
I'm trying not to play by play here, but I'm trying to keep it up.
Well, you know how you were talking about how they're going to have to sort of weaken them down into that sort of eco round. Well, that's another two rounds ahead. So if they actually manage to win this one out, stop that win, half win for Gambit. Look at the economy on the CT side. It's still quite disastrous, although the same can be said for Kingwin, but they are going to be able to bump into the next round, even if it's not a fully healthy one because the round lost bonus that is going to be coming into play. And Gambit, they have got a nice full buy here, but so have Kingwin. But look at this. The wall bang comes out. Mo is going to be able to do a lot of damage, Ferlin down to 1 HP. So unfortunately, this peak, look at that smoke peak. That is beautiful. That's the angles we want to be seeing. And talking about angles, Hobbit find the perfect one to Mihu. Mo going to be backing off with the flash coming out. He's going to get peaked though. Drop down to 1 HP as well. The return fire. Both AWPers going to be down to 1 HP. And we're going to be seeing the boost coming out over towards Truck, I think, in Bank. And we're going to be seeing the aggression in towards mid from the T side.
The ultimate test of the AWPs. Who's going to break first? Who is going to be the one that falls, the first man to fall on either side? And well, I guess we can decide definitively who is the better roper for these two teams. I think it'll be a fun little story we can build into. But 5-on-4, meanwhile, Kingwin at the disadvantage. Ferlin is going to position himself out towards that long area, looking out for Mo, who's got himself locked out towards the stairs area. So he's given up that long control. Kingwin have good access to it. 35 seconds on the clock, and it looks like they're going to have to commit towards this A site. Bombs are actually towards mid, so they can rotate if they want to, but they wouldn't be too smart with the current health situation of the Kingwin side. Although they have got themselves some presence. Looks like it will be the flashes and smokes. Here we go. AWP from Mo still takes that first, so back to a 3-on-5 situation. And, well, it will be Jarrett and Roland coming in towards the side hands. Here we go. Dozier with the backstab takes down one. Zeus gets Jarrett, and AWP from Ferlin does forward eventually. So it will be 8-5. Gambit have their CT half, and Kingwin will have one more buy back in them. And after this one, it is going to be a difficult end of the half for the Polish team.
Yes, they're just going to be going full in here, Jay. Trying to recover what they can. And they're going to be leaving only 3.2k at the end of this sort of a buy-up from these guys. They have got that AWP, but off of that round. It's going to be a little bit disappointing. I mean, obviously, Ferlin had got the AWP. Gary's going to be going back into his default, obviously, sort of spot. And Gary, he's going to be able to get a kill onto Hobbit as well. That was a very nice one. This time, they need to make sure they're not going to get rotated on. It happened again. Dozer are coming in from the side, slide angle, taking them out. No one was watching it. They're going to be able to get the win. So Gary going to be playing aggressive up to Fountain, looking for those early kills. He's already achieved that by taking down Hobbit. Got the opening. Now they've got the advantage wherever they go on sort of the man-on-man advantage. As long as the CTs don't go on solidly onto one site, which I don't think will happen. So we have got the bomb left behind, though. Hopefully not going to be pulling out a flip side and just forgetting about the bomb and end up losing the round due to it. Now, Ferlin going to be going head-to-head with Dozier, who's going to have his head popped. And so Zeus, that is fantastic. Now that's going to leave the B-side completely open. Mo, you're going to get taken down. Heads popping as Mozini are going to be able to pick up the final kill on Adren. And that's going to be the sixth round on the board for Kingwin, even though Gambit has won out this half. They're going to be able to buy into this round, but it's going to be a bit of a desperate affair here. The AWP is out. Hobbit going to have to opt in with partial armor, which is fine. You don't need head armor. Mo, though, he's going to have no armor at all. So going full glass cannon. And he did survive that with 1 HP as the push came in towards the A site. So I'm sure he'll be able to make it work. And he's going to be going over towards Long.
Gambit broken by Kingwin, shutting them down before they get through. And now Kingwin will just roll their way on through to what should be a seventh round. So, all in all, it will be good stuff. But Adren with two nice kills is going to shut down Ferlin and Roland. And now we're back to a 4-on-3 situation that favors Gambit slightly. Got two rifles they can pick up if someone wants to go daring. But, of course, it is still in T-site control. So, now just down to this CT side to try and hold things out from the rest of Kingwin here as well. There will be two players stacked up towards the monster area, one towards the short area. Bomb is still in T-side control, so Kingwin have got control of this round so far. But a minute to go now, they have to start making a play pretty quickly, and Zeus pretty tempted if he has the information to go for the CZ play here. No scope coming in from Jero, takes down the first, and then they will enter on towards the B side. Quick scope takes down Dozier, opens up the site, although Hobbit comes in the backhand side, takes down the bomb, and now it's up to Mo, who can't do anything. It will be an 8-7, a close scoreline. Kingwin will just about hold onto a decent one for their T-zone half.
Yeah, so getting seven rounds on the board, it's the sort of minimum you want to do on the T-side now. I mean, you really want to try and get some more on the board. CT side is not really the strongest that most people go for on the overpass from sort of previous experience. We're going to be seeing the full armor buy coming out from Kingwin, though. So no defuse kit. Nice, interesting play. CT side, we're going to be seeing Zeus drop over the Tech-9 over towards Mo. He's probably going to be playing a bit more sort of aggressiveness. And he has got that smoke as well, which is going to enable him to be able to push through. But where are they going to be playing? That's going to be the real question here. The bomb goes solo down in towards sewers. That's a dangerous play. Rest of them, they're going to be playing over towards Fountain, pushing on that Ferlin with the USB. He's going to get taken down. Adren going to be able to go in for that kill. And Mo with the Tech-9 charging down Long. It is his place. He wants to take full charge of it. The bomb is still alone over towards sewers. And Gary here, he's going to be pushing straight up to him. It's going to be very dangerous. Zeus, he's been completely countered in. The bomb has been shut down. They're going to be able to take him down. He is eventually going to get dropped. Look at this. Mihu, he's going to be able to take down Adren and Gary onto Mo. This is not looking so good, but Hobbit is going to be looking to make a recovery. It's going to be left in a 1v2. The heads are going to get popped. Gary going huge here. Picks up a 4k with that USP.
8-8. Team Kingwin evening the score once again on that pistol round. So all in all, that will actually be one pistol round apiece for both sides. So Gambit will now start to force buy into this round. No bomb plant, of course. So it will be the Tech-9s, the Deagles, P250s out. Head armor, no utility to work with. Of course, not enough money for that. But they're going to go fast towards connector. This could be very interesting if they try and go for a fast play to shut down Kingwin before they get started. Roland's going to see what you can try to find. Hobbit manages to get taken down to 13 HP, but not all of it shall be found. Now Kingwin on the back foot, but still have the better weaponry. The question is, can they shut down Gambit in time before they manage to get themselves straight up in their face, take some headshots, and well, kill the CT side.
Go, it might well be coming out, and Adren going to be able to get the kill. Mihu, potentially another one, as we're going to be seeing Ferlin trying to back off, but he's not going to be allowed to. That Deagle is hungry. Gara going in for the trade kills. Pork picks off one, but we're going to be seeing the MP9 make quick work of him. Takes away his health, and now Mazzini are going to be left in a 1v4. He's going to be pushing through. He's got the UMP, but the M4 is going to be coming out onto Mo, but he's going to get dropped nonetheless. The UMP going to be proven a little bit too strong, so two Ts of very low HP. 13 HP on Hobbit, 11 on Dozier. 100 on Adrenaline. Look at this, Hobbit. He's been a very sneaky one coming in from below. He's going to be able to get a tank. 9 kill. Taking out Marzinho, picking up the UMP. And that is going to be over towards Dozy, I'd imagine, because that is his preferred gun. And we're going to be seeing a buy coming out from Gambit. And you have to sort of compare the force rounds. Obviously, last half, we saw Team King win force into the second round. And they got absolutely destroyed trying to do that. And they ended up losing 5 rounds in a row before they managed to pick it up. Pick 5 rounds of their own, bring it to an equalizer, but then they lost 3 out. So going into the second half, we are going to be seeing Gambit win their force, burn up some extra UMPs, 2 AK-47s, and now Team King win, it's their time to try and force this up.
Gambit definitely with a better force buy, like you said, they're going to hold and maintain their lead against King Win. They've all got pistols to work with the King Win side, but Jero, when he's hitting no shots like that, it's not going to help him out whatsoever. And Dozier has the information. We'll drive him down to a corner with a grenade. He's going to do tons of damage and almost just about lands the spray. What's going on? Dozier finally able to land it. Try to land some deagle shots and will take down Michu as well. It's now back to a 3-on-5 situation. Peaking. Oh my god, Dozier! Hobbit also getting the final kill. 4 kills with deagles. Oh my god, that was absolutely ridiculous on the Gambit side. And King Green will be shut down very easily in that particular case. So 10 rounds on the board for the T side will be the way they shut down the King Green conversions.
Wow, sound like you almost got a little bit too excited there, Jay. might need to check yourself there. So we are going to be going into the next round. So Team King Green, they're going to be 2 rounds behind, and this is not what they want. So that fourth round did not work out for them at all, as Dozier just ended up tearing them apart even after missing so many shots. Now Gary going to be trying to make up for past discretions. It's not going to work. Even with so many shots going to be failing from Adren, can drop down to 22 HP. The kill comes out. The AK working in the favor of the T's. So these few pistol buys coming out from Team King Gwyn, they're going to have to try and utilize these the best they can, especially with only 4 players, no defuse kits. We're only going to be playing in for this early information. The smoke's coming out as well. I'm going to be blocking them off. Shun off that stair push as well. Grenade coming out from Mo, trying to do as much damage early on as possible. They're not playing too aggressive here. They want to make sure they can try and bait out any shots as possible. The important switch over of the bomb there, so the bomb planter hasn't got the lowest HP, but Miku, he does some damage to Zeus. Gets a nice headshot. It's going to work out in his favor. Now Marzinho pulls out a kill onto Dozier, looking for a second one. 2 bullets left in the mag. He's going to get dropped, and Mo, he's going to look for his second kill there. Spurlin, 73. Foxy has got the USP only. Now Renan, his footsteps has been heard. Adrian rather following him through the smoke. He's going to be able to get the kill. Followed up very closely by Mo. Taking the final kill onto Furlan with the AK-47, so it's going to be the force up and full buy, rather, from Team Kingwin. Imagine we'll be seeing some more SMGs on their side. No, that's going to be an AWP over towards Mihu, the only SMG is going to be on Garo. He's got the most utility. No defuse kits. And Gambit, though, they've got those 2 UMPs, 2 AK-47s, the AWP, and a buttload of utility.
Yeah, definitely a better buy for Gambit in this case. King Gwyn still going to be rocking 1 SMG, although that being said, Hobbit's got an SMG of his own right, so it will be the double orps. Well, sorry, just the double orps in general out for the team's Gambit with the one on Mo. And King Gwyn one on Michu. This is definitely a bit different. Furlan was kind of dominating the AWP during their T side half, so I wonder if there was any particular discussion, right, let's put the AWP on somebody else to try and get better results, but the Kingwin right now, it's not going to work out to their favor as Furlan's already fallen, so now it'll be the 4-on-5 situation. This CT side a little bit scattered, trying to rotate to necessary angles, but, well, Gambit have full map control here. They're up towards middle. They've got themselves out some prisons towards the monster area, and Kingwin haven't got any information on their side whatsoever, except maybe for a few footsteps that Rawlin's hearing in connector. But so far, there's not much coming in. 45 seconds, Rawlin's going to be able to take down a trench. So there's always that. Hobbit's going to flick himself around and take down one. A 3-on-4 situation is what will come into play.
I'm not even sure what happened there. Renan was right next to him the whole time. So we're going to be seeing the push over towards B. He's going to get denied that. Incendiary Grenade going to stop that push, but it's not going to deny him for too long, as they're going to be pushing in through Monster. And short, this double push is going to be very painful. But Gera going large, picks up 1, 2, 3. Or not going to be able to count to 4. He's going to have to go back to school for that, but Mihu with AWP going to go face-to-face with Dozier. The gun barrel's being spotted. The kill comes out, and that's going to be a round for Team Kingwin, who are looking to try and make a comeback, but they dropped 3 of their players. Gambit doing a fantastic job of keeping their economy quite low, even though they did drop that round. So AWP still in hands of the CETs. We're going to be able to see Mihu drop over a gun to his teammate, buy up a flash potentially, or maybe even save that cash. on T side, buying up nice and healthy. But they're not really going to be able to do that for too long, though, are they, Jay?
Definitely not. But for Kingwin, however, this could be their chance to make that unhealthiness a little bit quicker. Double AWP coming out for the CT side. A huge investment, but so far nothing's been working for this CT side in terms of their own gun rounds. So for Kingwin, this will start working out extremely well, especially if Michu's doing things like that and taking down two nice, a quick AWP kills onto Zeus and onto Dozier. So now we're back to a 3-on-5 to the favor of the Kingwin side. And now, well, Gambit has just sped three and across the entire map. They will try and formulate themselves together out towards the connected area. Or, as I say that, they're going to walk right past each other and head towards trying to get picks. So definitely not a place that I like to see out of this T side, but Kingwin will effectively shut this one down as Rowland gets a Dren. He is now just down to Hobbit and Mo to try and make something work in a 2v5. Unlikely is kind of the understatement as Hobbit gets spotted out. Rowland should just be able to take him down, as it should just be another round, a double-digit round on the board for Team Kingwin.
I really like the way they're playing, and Gary's going to be able to get the kill on Hobbit, so this double AWP setup really working for them. Now Mo going to be left in a 1v5. Some kind of miracle is going to happen if he's going to be able to pull this off. It's going to be very, very hard, but he is going over towards his patch. That's going to be long. He loves this area. He's an AWP player. He is on T side. He's going to be looking to push up, but Gary's got the AWP. He's going to be spotted in. The information's there. Now Mihu's who's there going to be looking to counter. The headshot comes out, though. Gary's going to be dropped. It's going to be Mihu over towards long. Still holding it off in case they tried to peek him, so when the AWP's dropped. Some damage done to the combo of Kingwin. But we do see Mo realize, unfortunately, he's not going to be able to clutch this out. He might be able to do some exit frags if they chase after him, but the economy is not there on the T side. They're going to have to save some cash. They should be able to try and... They could force up into the next round. I wouldn't recommend it, but it is a possibility. So we're going to be seeing round 10 on the board for Kingwin. Very nice round, and that double AWP setup really hit the sweet spot there. Mihu getting the two early kills very early on, and really effective. Gary's going to get dropped that AWP. Raylan... Excuse me, again, the drop of the M4 from Mihu. Or was it Miku?
I think it's Mishu.
Mishu.
I think that's what it is. Well, pronunciations aside, it will be the 10 down on the board for Team Kingwin and Gambit. In this case, they will force their way on through despite your better judgment. AWP out for Mo. And Kingwin will try and lock themselves out very similar angles. Jero out towards toilets, watching out on birthday party. And Dozier is going to peek right in, but actually take the kill. So that's not that bad coming in from the T side. Player Kingwin losing a man already. That's so difficult for them now, as it was one of those double orbs that they still have in play from a few rounds ago. Kingwin already losing out huge in that particular case. Now they're going to have to try and get the refrag or the trade out here. Zeus and Dozier almost launching into the clutches here. It will be Dozier that peeks out, tries to connect the spray onto Furlan as well, but barely spotted him out, stopped it right there, and that allowed him to go ahead and get that replay. The AWP from Zeus not going to land. It's going to be Furlan that connects the spray, but isn't able to land all of it onto Adren. Now a 3-on-2 situation. Definitely favors the Gambit side as Mazinho goes falling. Mishu, now a lone man, back towards the rotation angles. 45 seconds on the clock. Gambit should have this round on the board, but Mishu, well, he's got himself an AWP. What can you do with this one?
Save it. And that's going to be his best option moving forward. The economy is not there for them to be able to try and push this. They are going to be able to buy up into the next round if they want to force. But that's their only option. They can't buy up into it very healthily. And if they do that and then get shut down for a round, they're going to be reset. And it's not going to be very healthy. And talking of which, Hobbit's going to be looking very deadly unhealthy as he is going to get dropped. So some more economical damage coming out from Mihu there. And we're going to be seeing him save it and go back over towards Connector. But I think he's going to get challenged though. I think Gambit do want to try and save as much of their economy. They've only got two players who could potentially stay alive here, and that's going to be Adren and Mo. And look at the board there. Across the board, top amount is 650 on Adren and Mo. So if they can save this cash, they might be able to sort of force up on a few of the players next round. So yeah, there you go. They're going to be going into a full buy on Gambit. And it's going to be a bit of a gamble from Kingwin here. They need to try and utilize that AWP, but 4.6k, the top amount of cash on the CT side, not healthy at all. But we are going to be seeing the force come out, the UMPs, the M4s. This is an interesting play, and this is a massive gamble against Gambit on their map pick. They're currently two rounds behind as well on their map pick, so that's always important to note as well. The full buy coming out from Gambit, 4.8k's AWP, early grenade from Hobbit as well. Going to be able to do one point of damage, not quite the amount they wanted to. Mo going over towards Connector here, who is boosted up down. Waiting for the push through tunnels, but it's not going to happen yet.
No early tags coming in. Well, not no significant early tags coming in. Mishu down to 89 HP, but that's pretty much all that's pretty much significant here on this Kinguin side. 12 to 10 is the scoreline. And like you said, huge gamble from Kinguin, but so far it will pay off as finally Mishu is going to find that first pick onto Mo. That's a 4-on-5 situation as Kinguin will lock themselves down here. Mishu gonna peek out. Oh my god, almost landed himself a collateral. Only found the one right there. A 4-on-3 situation. A minute to go now. And Kinguin up to a 55-second situation to try and defend it here. Hobbit and Zeus and the Dren gonna try and formulate themselves a push here at some point.
Might well work. I mean, they've got the stronger buy here. They've got the AKs and the AWP, but Hobbit's on quite low HP. Renan could peek him and take him on here. Zeus, Hobbit, chucking in the molly here, going in for the aggression, and Zeus could get flashed out, and he's going to get down that. Raylan going to be looking to peek in, but it's not going to work. He's going to get taken down. He's going to be on a 3-on-3 situation, quickly switching up, but Gary's going to be coming up from behind. But look on the A site. Adren, he's read this perfectly. The rotation's going to be coming in. Zeus takes the kill onto Malzinho. The spray through the wall is going to be coming in, but it's not going to be working. Berlin's going to get taken down. Gary trying to go for a quick push. It's not going to happen. So they're going to be able to recover that AWP. The push from Berlin comes in. Heads are popped. Souls are lost. And now it's going to be down to Gary in a 1v3. But he's going to get taken down. Zeus did a fantastic job there of picking up 4 kills. And that force really did not work. So this is going to be able to help Gambit carry over in towards at least 14 rounds on the board to potentially even the match point. It depends on what Kinguin can really bring to the table here. If they buy up anything at all, it's going to be a high risk, and they're not going to even risk it here. It's just not worth it. They're going to try and just do the normal sort of setup across the map, try and get some kills, some information, and try and do, probably just try and save a weapon if they can get their hands on it. But what they haven't done is gang up in one spot, so that's going to be quite difficult with these default pistols.
Yeah, but default pistols is all they're going to have to work with in this case. It should just be a 14th round on the board for Gambit. And Kinguin just looking to buy those rifles in the next one and try and stop them from getting to that map point here. So, I mean, I'd say profoundly smart from Kinguin. Again, there is a little bit of risk that carries it. But in the end, you are going to have to put your faith into this next round anyway, because there is no way, or virtually a very slim chance, if you forced into this round, to be able to get themselves a round victory. So for Kinguin, I think it's probably the best option they could have taken given the circumstances, and they will just back off and hold some very smart angles at these Gera in particular, holding back towards behind the wall here of the short area. One other player also backing him up just in case he does go down for the refrag. So for Kinguin, I think there's no problems with this play. I just think that it's going to be a case that Gambit will slowly and surely get themselves closer and closer to that map point as well. There should just be the execution coming on through here. Kinguin can't do much. Actually, Farland does take down one headshot, lands a second, but not going to find much more than that here.
You say that, but we're going to be seeing another 2 kills come out, and Malzina going huge. What is going on? Mo, last player left alive. He gets a battle of USPs and the AK-47s. There's 3 of them. Mo's going to get dropped. That is going to be a full, almost full buy coming out here. That is going to be saved on the side of Kinguin. I mean, 3 AKs and AWP, what more could you ask for? So that's going to save their economy. That is a saving grace right there, and it's going to be pushing that Gambit right back onto the back foot here. We are going to be seeing the full buy coming out for them, but it is going to be limited in quite a lot of ways here. Deagle and Dozier, Tech 9 on Hobbit, AK-47s on the rest. Where's on team Kinguin is looking very healthy. I mean, Raylan, and look at this early peek. Gera going to get a kill onto Dozier. He may have only had the Deagle, but still, that is some high impact kills right there. He has done fantastically in the past, Dozier. But Hobbit going to get dropped as well. Mishu doing a fantastic job of keeping the bombsite B under their control. He's going to leave Zeus to try and get some kills. Adrian pushed a little bit too aggressively, a little bit too greedily. He's going to get dropped as Raylan picks up his first kill this round. And now, Mazzino. He's going to be able to pick up one for himself. So further than the last one left without a kill, he's not going to get chances. Gary picks up his second. That's going to be quick work of the T side. They had the guns, but they just couldn't get in the positions. Now Kinguin looking to take it to round 13 on the board, which will be the equalizer.
Just my luck, isn't it? I on the hyper map, a matchup saying, like, that's a full eco from Kinguin. There shouldn't be anything coming out. And suddenly they get themselves an AK, and then they just shut it down at 4-0. Well, and just like that as well, Gambit have entirely disappeared out of this matchup. Nothing coming in that last round. No picks. Nothing like that at all. And Kinguin will have themselves a 12th round. And Gambit will be up to the full eco on their side. A couple of PT-50s coming out. Deagles as well. But double peek coming in from Michu and Raylan. And Mo's going to go falling, so already Kingpin starting to punish here. It's going to be the early execution from the T side, but this is there's nothing they can do. There's nothing coming out in this round. Zeus and Dozier left alone. Fallen! Oh my god!
Vagban!
Fallen as well. Vagban, yes! Quick cool Volvo. 13-13. And Kingpin will just shut it down pretty easily. Gambit now up for the buy-up. Who is going to take the lead? More likely than anything, if Kingpin managed to take it, who is going to take the matchup? Because this round, especially if Kingpin win it, could pretty much put the nail in the coffin for the team that loses it.
But it's very close, though. That's the thing, and it's their map pick. Gambit doing fantastic, considering as far as HLTV goes, they haven't got too many rounds in this, games on this map, rather. So we're going to be seeing an aggressive play over in towards Park. They're pushing straight towards Long. They want to play and take this real estate from themselves. And Garou, he's going to be falling back over towards the A site with his teammate. And that's going to be Raylan backing him up there. The whole short push not going to be coming out too soon. Long push coming out from the CTs, though, looking to try and regain some control of the map, which they've given up a lot of so far. Mid control over in the T hands. Rotation back coming out from Adrian, a.k.a. Foon. Going to be looking to bop away here. Snow kills early on here. The aggressive push came out. The shot was missed by Gera there as he was boosted up in towards Picnic above the smoke. But now Adrian here looking to play with his teammates over towards the B site. That's going to be Malzinho looking to play against them. It's going to be quite hard.
50 seconds on the clock. Gambit look to set themselves up to the B site. Bomb is going back a little bit, so might be a fake potential rotation coming on through, but you can already see that Roland in particular has moved all the way up to the long area to try and cut that off if it does happen. 35 seconds, Gambit got to go quick. They're going to run this clock down low, and we've already seen one instance where dropping this bomb after such a low amount of time is going to cost them so dearly. Now they have to go. They have to go now, and Mozinho is going to spray down one. Furlan gets another Tekken kill. Tekken almost a third, and Mo's going to be left alone in a 1v3 now to try and make it work. It's not going to happen today. Mishu sprays him away at 40 HP, gets aggressive, and looks for that final kill. The flashbang comes out, but it doesn't stop the CT player from taking himself a double. 14th round on the board for Kingpin. Gambit didn't even get a bump on in that round, which is going to leave him up to one more force buy. One last chance to keep themselves in it. A fifth round loss bonus also coming out in the next round as well, assuming they lose. But it's on the ropes here for the Gambit team.
I think Kingpin just saying, you know what, we're just warming up. Just leave us to it. We're just warming up. So Gambit here going to be buying up quite heavily into this round, so not wanting to take it too sort of match point and have to go for overtime, but they are going to leave a little bit of spare cash to try and do that. Full armor on each one of the players, AK on Zeus, and he's going to be looking to enter in towards Shorten. He's going to get punished here as he's going to get taken down. Dozier picking up the AK-47. Vincent Grenade did fail, but the peak doesn't. He does a lot of damage from the Malzinho over towards Dozier. Now Mo, he's going to get sprayed through. These players are absolutely dirty here. The sprays through the smoke, the sprays through the walls are going to be happening. We're going to be seeing Gambit already punished very early on. And Team Kingpin looking very happy with themselves here, doing a fantastic combat. But Dozier, he's going to be able to take down Gera. That's going to be the first kill. But Raylan, he's in a good counter position to try and trade this back up and stop this push. He hears the footsteps. Hobbit going to be looking to push in. Adrian, he's got a perfect counter position against Mihu there. He's going to get dropped. AK in the hands, M4 as well. But it's going to be down to a 2-on-3 situation. Dozier gets the kill on Malzinho. This is exactly where they wanted to be positioned. The defuskits are still in the hands of Team Kingpin, as well as an incendiary grenade and a smoke. So it's going to be down to Dozier and Adrian to try and defend against this. And they have picked up the kill so far. It's going to be very difficult, though. Further, they're going to be coming in from Graffiti, exposing his head. It's going to be a little bit too much. Adrian to picking it off. Now, Raylan going to be left in a 1v2. He's done it before. Can he do it again? T's have backed off completely. The smoke going down. This is going to have to be a little bit of a ninja. He goes in for the defuse. It's going to be covered up. The key's going to be holding it. The spray comes out. It lands.
Oh.
And Adren picking up his third and final kill of that round. And he's going to be taking it to a 14-14. The buy-up from the rest of the players of the T is going to be coming out. The full buy coming in from Kingpin from that healthy bank balance they had. It's going to be getting chipped away down and the double AWP setup coming out. And this is what I wanted to see. It worked so well before. And they need to get these early kills. Nice and aggressive ones. Mihu before has previously picked up 2 kills very early on. And he's going to be playing over towards... I can't even see him there. Where is his number? He's going to be over towards B here, playing over towards short, nice and aggressive. A little bit of a different position.
Double ops out for King Wynn, like you said. It's been effective before, and this could be the play that they need to kind of shut down Gambit, as well as that huge investment from King Wynn as well. This one could end up falling at the drop of a dime, and if Gambit picked this one up, if Gambit are able to take themselves the round here, this could end up being 16-14 to their favor. If King Wynn take this round, it will definitely be 16-14 to their favor, of course. Down to just that low economy for the Gambit side, and a reset coming in for King Wynn will absolutely work wonders for them. A minute to go now. Gambit are going to run the clock down extremely low. This cost them big time last time. Question is, will it do so again? A minute to go. Oh my god, the AWP from Mishu almost finds it. 22 HP as the spray down does come in from Dozier, but it's not going to find the entire kill, so he'll get off just by the skin of his own teeth and back off to try and save the AWP to try and work from another angle. Gambit, meanwhile, got themselves out towards birthday party, out towards middle and out towards long. It looks like they're going to try and hold things down here for the Kinguin side on the A site. 35 seconds, Gambit. They need to act so quickly here. They've got one player pushing up very, very close in the middle area, two players out towards long, and they're running out of time. How long can they keep up this holding of their tongue?
I really don't know. So they're going to be looking to push in, and this is going to be the setting of the next round. Now Raylan in that smoke counter position takes down the bomb carrier. Garou onto Mo, Renan onto Dozier. This could be the end. They're going to get dropped hard and fast. Hobbit with the trade, but Malzini onto Dren. It's going to be down to Hobbit, who's going to get popped, and that's going to be the 15th round on the board for Team Kinguin. Are we going to be seeing overtime, or are we going to be seeing it go over towards Team Kinguin? Remember, this is their map, and they're going to have to fight tooth and nail here to try and bring it back and just finish it off. And Gambit, they're going to be forced into this one. They have no other options. They don't want to go lose this one, rather. They want to take a 2-0 series. It's currently 1-0. But Team Kinguin, they want to try and get one win on the round on the board here. Mo going to be picking up that Galil, the only rifle in the hands of the T's. The rest of them have got Galils and a Deagle, and they're going to be playing high pressure in towards sewers here.
Yeah, just the Tech-9s and Deagles out. The Molotov will do some damage to Hobbit as well. Kinguin reading this one almost like a book at this point, and then just looking out for anybody else who they spot. Mishu gets himself some information. Mo's going to be able to take down Rollin. And now we're back to 1 minute and 20 seconds. Gambit with the man advantage, but definitely not the weapon advantage. It's going to be up to Mo with, of course, that M4 in his hands to try and pick together whatever he can find. Kills onto the Kinguin side will work well for Gambit to go to overtime here, but even so, Tech-9s, they have to get the bomb down very quickly. I don't think they can afford to really go too slow here. Cost them in the last round, cost them in the round before. But 55 seconds still on the clock for this T side here, as it looks like bomb's on its way out towards the connector area. Jero is still watching out with the AWP, and I don't even know what Gambit are trying to find here. Hobbit's back towards a bit of a passive over towards Monster. All four players out towards short. Is this going to be a split, or what's going to go on here? It doesn't look like it's going to be the split, with the smoke coming out from Zeus, almost ready to try and find the pick here. And 30 seconds, Gambit. They need to move again. They're just so slow with these executions. Now the smoke will finally come out, and they will start executing on towards the site with a flashbang to try and blind them off. It will be Dozier getting one. Miles are going to get another one on tomorrow. And now a 4-on-3 will ensue as Gambit need to get this bomb down quickly. Miles Reno with a second one. 3-on with a further fourth. Oh my god, it's all falling apart for Gambit at the very last hurdle. Team Kinguin will take themselves a 1-1 at 16-14 on the second map of Overpass.
And what a fantastic series this has been between Gambit and Kinguin. So we are going to be seeing it ending in a 1-1. Each team winning their preferred map. And Team Kinguin only going to be able to win by the skin of their teeth. So very, very close. Mishu there and Yaro going to be able to pick up 23 kills each. Mazinia on 22 on the other side. Only one player breaks the 20 barrier. And that's going to be Dozier